Talent is cheaper than table salt. What separates the talented individual from the successful one is a lot of hard work. Stephen King. It is for you or for me or for anyone else. Hard work is the key ingredients to reach where we want to reach in our life. And today's guest is definitely a talented and a hardworking lady with whom we all will interact just in a while. With that, a warm welcome to all the viewers of People's Voice Season 3. How you doing all? I hope you all are doing great and enjoying weather if you are in Kuwait, because weather in Kuwait is just so beautiful. All the time I'm in my balcony having breakfast, dinner, lunch, and the most important thing, reading. All the time I'm in my balcony, and the only session which I come inside for is the People's Voice. And with that, I can see our guest, today's guest, is in the chat room. Let's invite her. Hi, Ikram, Nepali, Shivani. Let me just invite our guest. Just in few seconds. If you have, as I always say, if you have any questions, do comment in chat box and we will try to take it as much as possible. Hi, Shivani.
Hi, Naseema. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good. I was a little wary because, as I told you, this is my first session. And I actually went through a lot of material just to see how to start a live and how to join a live, because I somehow get very fidgety when technology doesn't go my way.
That's okay. I can understand. And you won't believe, most of our guests going live for the very first time. So it's fine.
No, yeah. And I figured that, yes, this is simpler than Facebook. You were right. And I'm glad that this is my first one, and I'm very happy to be doing it with you. And thank you very much for having me. Thank you so much.
No problem. Pleasure is all mine.
Thank you.
Shivani, we are just on time. Let's start our real conversation of People's Voice. But before that, let me briefly introduce you to our viewers. Okay? Dr. Shivani Salil Shinde. She is an Indian author based out of Hong Kong. Her first book, Hirayat, got published in August 2019. It is a single author anthology with 24 stories written around partition. It was selected among the top 100 debut novels for the year 2019-20 by Literature's Light and Critics Space Literary Journal. On the occasion of Women's Day this year, author Shivani was also awarded the Litroma Nari Samman 2024 Literature. She has just completed a year-long Master in Fine Arts, which is a full-time course in creative writing from Hong Kong University. With that, I warmly welcome you, Dr. Shivani, to People's Voice.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your warm words. And you make me sound much better than I think I am. Thank you. So,
my pleasure. Shivani, at the onset, now we all know what is your profession.
Yes.
You are a doctor with an MD in clinical microbiology.
Yes.
So how you got into writing? Can you throw some light on that?
As a child, actually, I wanted to do two things. I had plan A and plan B. Plan A was to become a doctor. If that fails, to get into English literature, because at that point of time, I used to think that that is the holy grail to become an author. I very badly wanted to have a book in my name, and that's where it must have started. But since I cleared my medical entrance, life went another way. I got busy with medical school, then post-graduation, life took over. So that dream was somewhere there, probably at the back of the mind. And finally, in 2017, I started with random blogs. The first one, in fact, was born out of more out of frustration. I was very mad at something and I just wanted to vent it out. And since I had been thinking of blogging by that time, I just thought I'd give it a shot. And that's how it started. People started, first it was the family and friends who were subjected to the torture. They were kind to me, and that probably gave me some encouragement, and I took it a little further. More platforms happened. I started following other bloggers because I was very new to all of this. 2017 is like 3 years ago, so it's not like once upon a time type of a story. So 3 years ago, I was a novice. I think I still am, actually. But I was fortunate to meet some really nice bloggers, and I made a lot of friends online, something I had never ever done before. I mean, today I'm talking to you because of Varuna, who I have never met. I have hardly interacted. We probably follow each other on Facebook, but beyond that, we had never spoken to each other. And yet she reached out. And so, I mean, things have fallen in place in a very beautiful manner for me. So, and I'm a Shah Rukh Khan fan. And so the way Shah Rukh Khan says ki abhi picture khatam nahi hui hai. So picture was still so probably, you know, this is the second half of my movie. That's how
awesome.
I feel. Yeah, that's how I feel about it. And
even I'm fan, big fan of Shah Rukh Khan. And the quote you have. I completely believe in that. And you know, as I started my research for authors, writer, I did realize many of them out there started writing out of frustration. It's one of the ways to vent out
Absolutely.
What's there in your mind.
Absolutely. Amazingly. I mean, my mother is an English literature student. She had long ago told me the word catharsis. And I probably never understood it till I actually started writing. So for me, writing has been extremely cathartic. Whatever I have felt, I may not have been able to say. If I just start writing, it calms me in a way nothing else has been able to.
Absolutely.
So for me, this Absolutely. Is a different kind of addiction, I would say. That's what
Absolutely.
I think. If I have to tell what writing for me means, I think it would be that.
Completely. That reminds me, I have written lately during COVID break a blog on writing is a remedy.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The pandemic, I think, has made people discover that I think all the people who have been discriminating against arts the pandemic must have made them realize that it is arts that they turn to in whichever form. Creativity in any form. It could be painting, it could be drawing, it could be writing. But most people in some or the other way have turned to arts to get over the gray period that the world has been through. So we cannot ignore that, no doubt about it. It is a remedy, definitely. I agree.
Yeah. Completely agree with you, and that takes me to your another work of writing, in specific Hirayat. Hirayat is your first book.
Yes.
And it is on
something
G.
I'm very proud of.
You should be. And it's a anthology of 24 stories.
Yes.
Shivani, can you talk a bit about the story, how you got the idea, what was the writing process looked like? Can you please share more insight about it?
In my case, I think these stories were the idea of writing was somewhere at the back of my mind. I think all these stories were getting saved in my mind somewhere. Because I come from a family of refugees. My grandparents had come from the other side, that crossed the border in 1947 after partition happened. So, although nobody talked about it in my family. It was always an undercurrent sort of, nobody mentioned the word, so to say, but then you gradually get introduced to the term refugee, you wonder what it is. Then you start hearing stray stories. There would be one line here or two lines there, how they struggled. But never a complete narrative as to exactly what happened in those few days. And mostly we talk about partition in terms of history, in terms of its historical significance. No one talks about the cost, the human cost to it, the millions that crossed the borders, both the sides. No one talks about the ordinary people. So I think that their stories need to be heard. And our generation is the last one to have been in touch with those people who lived through those times, my grandparents' generation. So, and how will my daughter or my nephew and nieces, they will know about these stories? There's no way to connect them. So there was, and since I was blogging by that time, I just thought of taking part in a blogging exercise, the blog chatter that happens every April. And you're supposed to write one blog a day on all the weekdays. So except Sundays, you have to be writing one blog every day. So it turns out to be around 26 blogs in a month. And at that time, I was very, I think it was false bravado that made me think I can churn out a story every day. Of course, I prepared a little bit before that, and that's how it started. I interspersed them with some non-fiction posts as well, because I realized 26 stories are not going to come out just like that. It is going to take a while. But it happened, and the stories just flew. A lot of people tell me I was possessed at that time, because I was just scribbling away furiously, or rather I should say typing away furiously on the keyboard. Wherever I was sitting, I was thinking, I was obsessed. There's no doubt about that. I mean, if I look back at April 2019, it was a very different time. I think it was one heady time, I would say. I don't know if ever I will experience anything like that again. And as the blog started coming out, people started reading the blogs. It got appreciated, because for a long time nobody had probably spoken about partition. And since these stories were inspired from true events, maybe that's what got people interested. And they were not your regular, they were not the historical perspective. They were stories about common people who were caught in uncommon circumstances. As the
True,
blog
true.
gained some sort of a popularity, I got ambitious. I thought I should put out a book. Initially, I thought it would be a Kindle, but then I approached some publishers I had again met online. I was rejected by two, but the third one they accepted, and that's how the book came out. It came out in August 2019. It went through various drafts, but I really badly wanted to come it, it to come around 15th August, so that's how it happened. So those 3 4 months
Amazing.
were I mean, I still get goosebumps when I talk about it.
But Shivani, this is, I think, obvious in any field. If you want to do something very passionately, that kind of obsession needs to be there to
Absolutely.
get the quality of out of anyone.
Yeah, you are true. I mean, but see, I always wanted to become a doctor as well, and I have experienced that passion. It's not that I haven't, but the kind of burst that I had during that time is something I would really want to go through it again, just for the sake of that experience. It was out of the world. It was something very, very different.
I'm sure, I'm sure. And that takes us to your writing work. You were talking about blogs and the online portal where you write. And I read in your bio that you write regularly. You write the week, I think it's weekly space on
Yes.
online portal, the Wonder Woman World, called Saturdays with Shivani.
Yes.
What what's the usual content on that space looks like? What are the things you're posting there?
Saturdays with Shivani's happened last year in January. So 2019 January, I think Charmaine, who runs this portal, she approached me and she said, "Would you want to write a weekly?" And when I was a child, I mean, at that time newspapers were very popular, and there used to be weekly columns, especially on all days there used to be certain weekly columns, and we would be following them. And you have those wild dreams that, you know, one day you should have a weekly of your own. So I was very happy to be offered that. I mean, what more could I ask for? And she was very
Excellent.
clear that I can write whatever I want to write. The blogs had to be
Okay.
around 600 to 800 words at the most, and it could be on anything that I wanted. That kind of freedom and a weekly space is something that I was probably looking for. And it has given me the discipline to write. There are times when every week I think, if I don't write this week, maybe it'll be fine. But I end up writing by Thursday night. I end up writing, and by Friday morning at the most, I send it to her, because I don't know. I mean, it's just a sense of discipline. And as for the topics, they are very random. If there's something topical happening in the week that has me thinking, why I got a haircut. I mean, I buzzed my hair off in the pandemic. So my last week's topic was why I did that, for example. Then once it was about, it's often about relationships, about parenting. Sometimes it's about my daughter, which she really hates, because she then stops having conversations with me, because, and she tells everyone, don't talk to my mother, or be very careful when you talk to her, because she can use it against you. She'll write a blog about you. So that is that's what Saturdays with Shivani is. They're very random conversations. I love to talk to people. And now that I'm so far away from home and so far away from the people I used to enjoy talking to, somehow this platform gives me a feeling that I'm talking to all of those and everyone who reads it. So it's more or less a conversation, I would say.
So the content, it wouldn't be wrong to say that it's a incidence of your life, the things which is happening around you,
Absolutely.
you're just taking the key element from there, polishing up and publishing it.
True. Yeah, I think you can say that.
Nice to hear that. Shivani, I mentioned in my introduction about you that you have done a creative writing course.
Yes.
And and I know there are guests who came to our People's Voice. They have mentioned how it had helped to get a structure in their writing. So after having this creative writing course from Hong Kong University for a year, how it had helped you in writing?
See, I don't come from a literary background. I was a student of science. So for me, writing a book on a random this thing, it was a random wish at that time. But while I was going through the process of editing and drafting, redrafting, and when all those drafts were happening, I started feeling that I have enjoyed this process a lot. And having said that, I also knew that I am not good at it. I am not. I wrote it because I felt that I should be writing it. But beyond that, the craft is there is a certain finesse to the craft, which I probably do not possess. And that is how I applied for this course. And although I never thought I'd be selected, it was again a random act, which is probably my hallmark now. So I applied and I sent my writing samples, and they happened to select me. And I enjoyed the interactions. It was a very informal, I would say, sort of a course to begin with. And gradually we were led to unlearn a lot of things. That's how my director would probably describe it. That, you know, she would say that you will take the first 6 to 8 weeks to unlearn what you've learned, and then you will start learning, you will start picking up the nuances. And that's probably exactly, I think, rather exactly what happened. Because in the initial few weeks, we were all completely dazed as to what's happening. We were supposed to submit our stories, and we were critiqued. We were supposed to read certain things, and we had writing assignments. But gradually, we realized that we are being led into a certain structure. And also the finer things about writing that we may never ever be able to appreciate as a reader. So now when I read a book, the experience is no longer the same that probably I had a year ago. Because with every
Okay.
line, I'm probably wondering about the perspective, the narration, the point of view, and of course the sentence construction, how there are no extra words anywhere. So, those finer things in writing that probably I would never have paid attention to till I joined the course. However, after
Okay.
having finished the course, I realized that I am back at the starting point, or maybe even much before that, I would say. So there's a lot of hard work that I've cut out for myself. And I think that's one thing that the course has told me. It's like you need some amount of knowledge to know the level of your ignorance. So today I know that I have just started this, and it's a long walk from here. But definitely, for someone like me, yes, the course has helped. I can't say for everybody. But as I said, that I am the kind of person, if I'm not, if I start a thing, I need to get into it totally. So even if I had to do an Instagram with you, I had to do my research before that as to how to get into the video. So if for a live, I could spend that time, I had to be, so imagine if I have to write a book and then how I would feel about it. So I probably lean towards perfection, being a perfectionist, which is, I mean, which it's working well for me, I would say. So, but to each his
I'm
own, I think.
sure. Like we both are in a way alike, no matter how short duration of a program session or a book it is, we like to do our homework. Th basically,
Absolutely.
this is what
True.
you say. Yeah.
Right.
I believe that this writing schools, going to writing school, give us a professional approach to what we want to do.
Right.
If I'm
That, and also
Can
they
you
help you find your strengths and discover your weaknesses. Something that we may not be able to find ourselves, and something that even our peers, however honest they might be, may not be able to point it out to us. Whereas, and I was very fortunate to join a very, I mean, it's a premier institution. So, I mean, I couldn't be more fortunate, I would say.
Absolutely. Shivani, we are almost towards the end, so I have one or two more questions. I'll try to take that very quickly. We are having a questions, few comments, but due to the lack of time, I may not be able to take those questions, but there are so many lovely comments for you. We are proud of you. You are an awesome writer. We've read your book. Beautiful comments like that.
No, people have been kind to me.
I'm sure. I'm sure. Shivani, writing is something quite complicated, time-consuming. Just for a book, years of time one needs to invest. So I'm sure the process must be getting taxing at times. What is the way out for you? How you de-stress yourself?
Okay. The thing is, my background now. I think nothing could be more taxing than medical school, probably. So it prepares you for, I mean, anything else looks a piece of cake, frankly. And having said that, I cannot compare or belittle the two professions, because writing has its own pitfalls. And it's a very lonely job. And for someone like me, who I would say is, I like to be surrounded with people, and I love to talk, but the past 2 years have told me that this is going to be a very lonely walk. So there are times, again, I'm sorry, I'm quoting my daughter, but she has been telling people that my mother stares outside the window, writes two sentences, and she calls it work. So that is the kind of thing that happens with writers, that often they all they can get out is two lines, but there are times when words just flow out. So yes, that's something I was not prepared for. I am the kind of person, I knew that this is my syllabus, this is what I'm supposed to read, these are the references I need to. So that is how I had been trained till now. That unlearning has been a major aspect. So I'm trying to be kind to myself. I tell myself that it's okay. I talk to people who I have learned to rely upon, be it my family or some of my friends. And then I am a big movie buff and web series fan, so thank God for Netflix. That's how I unwind, and then I come back. And if I stay away from writing for too long, I've realized I get sleepless, which is something that never happened with me before. The other day, I was telling my husband that I had never complained of losing sleep, but I have realized that there's a pattern to me that if I do not write for a long time, I start getting sleepless. So I know that it's time to go back and, just start writing. Give yourself time, just take 2 steps back and then bounce back into the scene. I think that works well for me.
Oh, I'm sure it does. And writing is something, it's completely involves a thought process. You have to zone out, zone in all the time. Sometimes you are with people, but you are not there.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that I experience a lot. Even for, I'm not writing a book, just when I am into my blog writing phase, this is what I, even if I'm in office surrounded with colleagues, my mind is somewhere else.
Yeah,
I should not say that in this live, but yeah.
no, that's okay. You literally see through people. It's like they're no longer in the room with you. And the
True,
ones who
true.
are around me, the ones who know me well, they know that look of mine now. So they leave me in peace that she has zoned out now, so there's no point talking to her. So they realize. I think it's
I'm
about
sure.
identifying, it's about identifying your how your mind processes, how your mind works, what your personality is, what time of the day you're more comfortable. I am a person who's more comfortable in the night. But a lot of authors I know, they sit and write in the mornings. So I think it's an individual thing that you need to chart out how to
True.
deal with it. Yes.
Shivani, it was lovely chatting with you. There were so many good comments that whatever you have spoken in last 20, 25 minutes, they are just your journey is giving them tips. They can feel you what you have gone through. So before we sign off, any advice that you would like to share with aspiring writers?
Right. That's all you can do. Write and read and write and read and repeat. And never be afraid of criticism. Take it with a pinch of salt. If you believe that somewhere deep down, we are all honest with ourselves at the end of the day. We know if that criticism is right or not. If it is, go ahead. Even if you have to work harder, you have to rewrite, it doesn't matter because eventually you will be proud of the end product. However, don't take all the criticisms to heart as well. I mean that it should not discourage you totally. Your work
True.
will invite comments of both the types, and I am learning to live with that myself. So I think everybody needs to find a balance. Take whatever comes your way and utilize it to improve your craft. That's what I would say.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Just take the constructive criticism, what you feel that will help you to enhance the quality of your writing and take you to the next level. And rest, you can always leave it behind.
Just shut it down.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Dr. Shivani. It was lovely chatting with you. Thank you for giving your time. It's our pleasure to have you on People's Voice Season 3.
Thank you, Naseema. I think the honor is mine, the pleasure is mine, and thank you for introducing me to Instagram finally. I have been very lazy with it. I did have an account for a long time, but I never did anything about it. So thank you for that, and thank you for having me. I enjoy talking to you a lot. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Shivani. Take care. Have a nice
Yes.
evening.
Thank you,
Bye-bye.
everyone who took out the time to watch and write such lovely comments. I have been reading them as much as I can, but surely I'll revert once this is done. Thank you, everyone, and thank you again, Nasima.
Thank you,
All right.
Shivani.
Good
Take
night.
care.
Yes, thank you.
So that was Dr. Shivani. As she said, keep writing, repeating, and just again start writing. Because Jordi Picoult, he rightly said, you can always edit a bad page, but you can't edit a blank page. So pick up your pen, start writing, edit it, and just keep going on that path where you want to be a writer. With that, thank you so much for all your lovely comments, feedback. Keep writing. Take care. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Signing off, Naseema Khan. Bye-bye.